spanning the globe.
Oh, my. Have you been a naughty, naughty world?
Hold it, Munch. He said spanning the globe, not spanking the globe.
It's time for the Chuck E. Cheese News.
Well, hello, news watchers. Have I got a story for you? Well, have I? Now, where did I do it? Oh, here it is. Ladies and gentlemen, this just in. Okay, that was just in, and this is just out. In, out. In, out. Okay? Boy, am I glad we finally got that cleared up. Now, let's see. What's in the news? History was made today when our own Pasqually became the first pizza cook to set foot on the moon. And now, let's talk to him live. Come in, Pasqually. Come in.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, boy, that's a mess.
Come in, Pasqually.
Chucky and TV people. Ciao, everybody. Hello, Mama.
Pasqually, just why did you want to be the first pizza cook on the moon?
Well, Chucky, I'd heard the moon was made of green cheese, but I just couldn't believe it. Now that I'm here, I see that it's not green cheese. It's mozzarella cheese, just like I thought.
Fascinating. Any other discoveries?
Why, sure. The surface of the moon has a very unusual crust.
What's unusual about it?
Well, it's chewy, yet crisp, and has just a touch of garlic to
now,
it.
Hold on.
Oh, I've also discovered that the moon's mountains are mushrooms and the craters really pepperoni.
Pasqually, are you trying to tell us that the moon is really a giant pizza? That idea sounds half-baked to me.
Well, it is half-baked. I'd recommend putting the whole moon into a 350-degree oven for about another 20 minutes or so. And then, perfecto! And now, back to you, Jackie.
Thank you, Pasqually. Well, folks, that report from outer space has run us out of time. So, until next time, this is Chuck E. Cheese saying, if something important is happening somewhere, it's news to me.